In the past few weeks, Canva free account users have been discovering that the Create Template Link function has started to become exclusive to Canva Pro account users. This function is the lifeblood of Etsy shop owners like me who sell Canva templates, because this allows customers to modify the templates on their own accounts without actually making changes to the main file. Now, we might need to be subscribed to Canva's Pro plan if we want to create shareable template links, which would cost an additional $10 per month. Technically, there is a way around this without the need for a Pro account, which I will share in a few. But as of the recording of this video, I have yet to see an official statement regarding this change. I don't know if I missed a newsletter, but I've been seeing multiple posts about this on Facebook groups and on Reddit. Personally, on my main Canva account, which is a free account which hosts hundreds of my shared templates, this change has not yet come into effect. So it seems like they're pushing this change gradually among Canva free account users. But in my side Canva account, which I just made earlier this year, this update can already be seen on the upper right options where this feature is located. And again, I haven't seen any official news on this yet, but on Reddit, some people have even reported that their links have been broken, possibly because of this change. While others say that despite the update, their links have remained intact and pre-existing templates have stayed shareable. It's only when they create new templates that they are required to have a Pro account. So if you're a digital product seller like me who uses mainly Canva, or if you share templates a lot for work or whatever, be sure to double check your links so people won't suddenly come to you complaining about broken links and asking for a refund. Of course, the easiest fix for our prevention for future problems would simply be to upgrade to a Pro account. And honestly, I think it was just a matter of time before this became a paid feature, seeing as people do make a lot of money selling Canva templates. So if you want to keep sharing template links hassle-free, this might be an additional necessary business expense from now on. But I do understand that maybe if you're just beginning at selling digital products, or if you share templates for no profit at all, then subscribing to a Canva Pro account might not be something that you would be ready to spend on just yet. And I get it. So here's how you can share templates without a Canva Pro account. Now what you can do is when you go to share, create a collaboration link. And then on the drop-down, anyone with a link can view. Then make sure it's limited to view only. This is the link that you'll be sending to your customers or clients. Now when people click on that link, they won't be able to edit the template. They will need to go to File and click on Make a Copy. Once they do this, this will make a copy into their own account and only then can they start editing. Do not share the link and change permissions to Can Edit. Otherwise, everyone who has access to this link will be overwriting the original and people can start working over each other's outputs, and this can inadvertently disclose some personal information as well, like addresses or names, especially if you're selling something like invitations. So you want to avoid that and keep the collaboration link permission to view only. Now in your PDF or packaging where you attach the link, it's very important that you give these instructions that they need to go to File and make a copy. Otherwise, you might be bombarded with complaints saying that they can't edit the template. For example, here's my PDF, and I have here an important README section. You can even include these instructions on the first page of your template as a deletable page. I also highly recommend putting this instruction on your listing photos and your description. Aside from Canva templates, some of my products are Google Sheets, and this is basically how Google Sheets or documents are shared. You give them the link and they have to make a copy, and trust me when I say that even when you have these instructions clear as day on your attached PDF, your photos, and your description, some people are just pains in the butt and they won't even bother to read. They might be even quick to complain about how they can't edit the thing. So they might send messages and even ask for a refund even when the instructions are literally there. I have even gotten a 1-star review because of this, which fortunately I was able to have removed. But yeah, consider this a cautionary tale for me. This method may save you a few dollars per month, but it can come with headaches and the need for extra customer service. So personally, I'm upgrading my account to Pro because I don't want to deal with that and have another bad review. Anyway, if I do get any official updates on this, I will be sharing them on this channel. So if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button. It helps me a lot. And if you're into selling digital products or selling on Etsy in general or discovering side hustles, please subscribe and I will see you on the next video.